Today's digital camcorders have exceptional quality, very close to professional, and yet you can probably tell in about 5 seconds whether a piece of footage was professionally shot or shot by an amateur. I think the primary problem here is that it wasn't shot on a tripod. The difference between amateur footage and professional footage very often is that the amateur footage is not steady. First of all, use the human tripod, a little thing I like to call your elbows. Hold the camera with two hands, put your elbows against your rib cage. This is extremely steady, especially in conjunction with that built-in image stabilizer. By a quirk of science, it turns out that the average table lamp has screw threads right here. By happy coincidence, they are exactly the same diameter of a camcorder tripod socket. And there you go, instant improvised tripod. Let's face it, if it weren't for kids and pets, there would be no camcorders in the world at all. But notice the camera angle. Dan is shooting down on his own kid. All he's succeeding in doing is creating a memory of his own view. When you're shooting children or pets, take the camcorder like this and go to the kid or the pet's level, like this. Compare that bit of footage with footage of my own cute blonde-headed boy, filming him at child's eye view. So you get a memory of sort of his version of the memories of that day. And one more thing about children and pets, they never perform on cue. So tape is cheap. Let the camera roll. You can always go home and edit out the boring parts. I've got more tips for you too on lighting, sound, editing, and uploading to the web, but you're gonna have to watch the complete TV episode for that one.